Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Flipping physics.
We have a rectangular conducting loop, a rectangular wire loop in a uniform magnetic field oriented like this. Recognize that in the front view, all you are going to see of the rectangular conducting loop is a straight line representing one side of the loop.
Hold up. I don't get it. Did you just say the magnetic field is oriented like this? I don't get it. What is like this?
Oh, I'm sorry, Bo. I can see how that was confusing. What I meant to say is that in the front view, the magnetic field is to your right, and the loop is oriented like this.
Okay, I guess that makes sense. The magnetic field is to the right. Okay.
Yes, and again, just to be absolutely clear, in the front view, all you are going to see of the rectangular conducting loop is a straight line representing one side of the loop. When you look at the loop from the top view, you get the top view, and you can now see the full rectangular conducting loop, which I am again using a picture frame to represent. In this example, we are going to place an EMF across the loop to cause current, capital I, in the loop. In the top view, you can see the current we are placing on the loop is clockwise. This means when looking at the front view, the current is coming out of the screen on the right side of the loop, and the current is going into the screen on the left side of the loop. Because conventional current represents the motion of positive charges in the wire, we can use the right-hand rule to determine the directions of the induced magnetic forces on, in the front view, the left and right sides of the loop. Bobby, please do that.
For the current coming out of the screen on the right side of the rectangular loop in the front view, fingers point out of the screen in the direction of the current, fingers curl to the right in the direction of the magnetic field, and thumb points up in the direction of the induced magnetic force on the right side of the loop. For the current going into the screen on the left side of the rectangular loop, still in the front view, fingers point into the screen in the direction of the current. Fingers curl to the right in the direction of the magnetic field. And thumb points down in the direction of the induced magnetic force on the left side of the loop. Oh, okay, I get it. There is a net torque acting on the loop from the current passing through the wires in the uniform magnetic field.
Exactly. And let's add an insulated hinge in the middle of the rectangular loop, which allows the current carrying loop to rotate around that axis of rotation. You can see I have added that axis of rotation in the top view and in the front view. And I've shown that the wire loop will angularly accelerate in the counterclockwise direction in the front view.
In the top view, the induced magnetic force on the wire on the right side is out of the screen, and the induced magnetic force on the wire on the left side is into the screen. Right, Mr. P? Why are we not adding those to the illustration?
Yes, Bo, you are correct. Honestly, there is so much going on here that if I were to include everything in these illustrations, they would be so crowded that they would not help you see what is going on. So I am being selective about what I show you in the illustrations. For example, I need to add a side view so we can understand what happens here. So again, this represents the rectangular conducting wire loop from the top. This represents the conducting wire loop from the front. And this represents the conducting wire loop from the side. In the side view, all you see is the one side of the wire loop, which looks just like a line. And the axis of rotation around which the wire loop rotates passes through that line. And this is just the initial position of the rectangular conducting wire loop. As we showed, there is a net torque acting on the loop, which causes it to angularly accelerate. In the front view perspective, in the counterclockwise direction. After the loop has rotated 90 degrees, we arrived at what I am identifying as the final position of the rectangular conducting wire loop. Again, in the front view, the wire loop rotates from the initial position here to the final position here. In this final position in the top view, the loop looks like a line. In the front view, the loop also looks like a line. And in the side view, you can see the rectangular shape of the loop. At this final point in the front view, you can see the current in the top wire is still out of the screen, causing an induced magnetic force, which is still upward. The current in the bottom wire in the front view is still into the screen, causing an induced magnetic force, which is still downward.
That means there is zero net torque caused by the induced magnetic forces on the loop at the final position, right, Mr. P?
That is correct, Billy. And notice that the current which is out of the screen in the top wire in the front view is to the left in the top wire in the side view. And the current which is into the screen in the bottom wire in the front view is to the right in the bottom wire in the side view. That means the current in the wire loop in the final position in the side view is counterclockwise.
You know, this is a lot. You're just talking about current passing through a wire loop in a magnetic field, right? I mean, where would we ever see something like this?
This is the basics of how an electric motor works.
Cool. Right.
There is a lot more to how electric motors work, which we are not going to discuss today. However, what we have shown here is the basic concept. Electrical energy is used to create current in wire loops in magnetic fields, and that causes the loops to rotate, effectively converting electrical energy to mechanical energy to rotate things like engines.
Sure.
That seems pretty useful.
Yeah.
Yep.
It is.
Thank you for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.